So this video is the continuation of our orthoptic series that I started, where today I am going to discuss with you all about negative fusional vergence. So this negative fusional vergence test is actually done to see what is the maximum ability of the patient to diverge his eyes. Where to perform this test, we actually use this base in prism, and base in means the base of the prism is actually placed nasally and apex is towards the towards temporal side. Okay. Yeah, you need to allow the patient to see binocularly, where you will place the prism bar, basin prism bar, in front of one eye, and the target will be a line target or a dot target, but you should not give the patient a letter target because it can induce accommodation. But we are checking the patient ability to diverge, so here accommodation will be unchanged. Okay, so that's why you need to give the patient a line target. And the patient will allow to see binocularly to the distant target, and the base in prism bar power, you need to increase the prism bar power from lower value to higher value, where you can see this is the lower value, 1, 2, 4, 6, 8, 12 prism diopter. So you need to increase the prism dioptrical power in a gradual manner. And you need to instruct the patient to inform you that whenever when he is seeing this line target, and when this line target will get double while you are actually increasing the prism bar dioptrical power, then the patient will inform you that yes, the line is actually in a double manner. So, and at a point will come where the patient will say that yes, the lines are appearing double manner, and he is not able to make it single. So you need to record that line in a, or as a, what to say, break point. Okay, so this test is actually done for both distant and near. So here in both distant and near, distance is done for 6 meter, near is done for 40 centimeter, where you will give the patient a line target to the patient, and patient is seeing binocular to the target. So after performing or after getting the break point, where the patient will say that the line is actually in a double manner, that is the break point, then you need to reduce the prism dioptrical power from higher value to lower value. And when the patient will say that this double line is actually in a single manner, then that is the recovery point. So you need to record the break point and recovery point for both distant and near in both eye, for right eye and left eye both. And these are the normal value, where for distance the break point is actually 7 plus minus 3 prism diopter, and recovery it is 4 plus minus 2 prism diopter, and for near it is 13 plus minus 6 prism diopter, and recovery is 10 plus minus 5 prism diopter. So here, suppose the patient prism dioptrical power for the distant break point is actually 15 prism diopter, it is indicating that the patient is actually having convergence insufficiency. And if it is less than 7, like 5 prism diopter, it is indicating convergence excess. So this is how for same for both distant and near. So you need to perform all these things test in your daily OPD, so that it will give you good practice for this negative fusional vergence. So in the next video, I will discuss with you all about positive fusional vergence. So that's all, friends. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to like my video, subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for kindly listening.